You notice that very interesting text, a very interesting thing that Jesus said in the past, of course, stands today, especially at this end of the New Covenant era, where he said, the time will come when they that kill you will think they do God's service. Kill us in the name of the Lord God of Israel. Now that had initial fulfillment because the Jews set about killing Christians wholesale. In Jerusalem, horrendous persecution happened right way back then. And the Christians were scattered all over the place, driven away as best they could anyway. Even today, it's common, quite common, to hear stories of people who are converts from Judaism to Christianity being found dead under a pile of rocks in the back streets of Jerusalem. They're still at it today, just the same. But actually, you know, that hasn't been so. We've had peace for a long time. And I pray regularly, I speak with my Lord and pray that he will control the government and will stop them siding with pagans, and they will keep it all down, and that he won't allow this Babylonian get-together that you see going on everywhere. There's extremely sinister stuff going on behind the scenes. And in recent days, of course, I've already said in the past, some time ago, you'll remember me saying, if you watch my videos, that there's a reason why the Satanic Institute of the European Union, which is defiance of God's work post the Tower of Babel, God's work is division, not unity. There's a reason why that was treaty. The EU was founded under the Treaty of Rome, wasn't it? Okay. And recently there's been the 60th anniversary, he sticks his neck out, I think it was, of the initial signing of the initial opening document for this united Europe. Europe has never been a united except under satanic rule from the Vatican a long time ago. Never been united, always been at war and fighting and difference and divisions. Why is there divisions? God made it so. He divided the countries up to their own space, their own language, their own culture. He made things different, and those that start coming against him are coming against God. And when they founded this satanic enterprise of the European Union, they were trying to rebuild the Tower of Babel and redo Babylon again. Here they are having another go at it. Absolutely crazy. And they're taking on God and they think they're going to get away with it. Nuts. They won't get away with it. They're fighting God. And if you think you're fighting God, you're going to fight God and you'll get away with it. Not a chance. I can think of a few instances, even at a personal level, where people have come against me and attacked me personally for preaching the truth of God, and they've been struck down. I know, struck down seriously ill. One particular person I'm thinking of been struck down with conditions I really, really wouldn't want to have. Another one, he was struck down with horrible stuff. I have seen people being put under demonic chastisement. Why? They attacked the truth of God. And if so, those of you come against you and I who preach the truth of God, like those people in some distant past I'm talking about, who did to me, then don't be surprised if God strikes them down. Will you? And I've seen a number struck down, of course, and if we turn against Jesus Christ, who's the truth of God, we can expect the same thing. You know, the Lord's no respecter of persons. It makes you sit up and pay attention a bit, doesn't it? However, recently, for the 60th anniversary, just as the UK is leaving the EU, thank God, and the bondage and the prison of the European Union, the European leaders went to Rome for a 60th anniversary meeting, and they went to Satan's World headquarters, and you can see actually what the real thing is about the European Union. Take a look at this picture. Now then, who is behind the European Union? Well, the Antichrist is there at the center. All these leaders, the European leaders, there they are, because it is a Roman Catholic enterprise and a Catholic state. Now, Christians repudiate and reject Catholicism, absolutely. Cursed religion, and the Lord God curse and destroy it, is my view. And I hope you agree. Let's pray, Lord God, destroy Frankie's enterprise. But here, you see in that particular picture there, all the leaders of the European Union. To the left of Frankie and one step back is Angela Merkel, the German leader. And you'll recognize one or two others too, is Donald Tusk in the front row. Or Tusk, I think they pronounce it. You'll forgive me if I messed it up. But nevertheless, it's a Roman Catholic enterprise. And you'll notice that why do they go to a mere religious leader? Virtually no one there in that group actually practices the religion of Catholicism. Why are they having anything to do with the religious leader? Why, for instance, don't they go to some chief mullah of the psychotic warlord religion or priest of Hinduism or something? Why do they go, or Jewish leader, why don't they go to Israel and stand with some rabbi or something? The reason's very simple. Actually, it's Roman Catholicism trying to regain control and power over Europe and notably the UK. They've been trying to get hold of the UK, what they call Mary's dowry, for a very long time, having lost control in God's work of the Reformation, when the Lord God used a wicked, wicked man and to put the Catholics' light in between the Christian killing Catholics and the children of God, so we could have peace. So let's all pray that Frankie's mob do not get control of the UK, that they can have Europe and they can get down to some serious wickedness and evil in Europe, as Catholic countries are famous for. And let's pray that our God keeps this country clean and free from all that. This does not look good for us, though, does it, at one particular time? Because, through history, you've had the murderous pagans, the Roman Catholics, who confess officially to the murder of 63 million people through their history. 63 million. Some figures are up to 180 million. A little while ago, when a previous Antichrist, his prancing putrescence Antichrist JP2, went senile, just before he went senile and died, made a confession for the sins of the church, like, whoops, we killed 63 million people through history, and we apologize, we saw that, like, whoops, I accidentally kicked your cat, or oh dear, I've thrown a stone and it's knocked over your favourite daffodil in the front garden. 63 million murdered. In the UK right now, there are heavyweight conservative historians, secular historians with no axe to grind. These people set the number murdered by the Catholics through history at 50 to 55 million. But we'll take the official confession of 63 million given by Antichrist JP2, and we can start with that. That is nearly the entire current population of the UK, minus the population of the city of Bristol. Everybody else wiped out. Now, this should be a fair indication that something's a bit wrong here. They can't possibly be disciples of Jesus Christ. They must be Satan's people. That kind of unspeakable evil is not anything to do with Yahweh, the Lord God of Israel. You can't impose the gospel of Jesus on people. at all. It's not possible. Now, we don't live as Protestants as some kind of juxtaposition with Frankie's mob. Why would we bother with them? You know, they're just like Hindus, Buddhists or Sikhs or Muslims or something. They're around, we don't take any notice of them, we just get on with our Lord, don't we? But let's just be aware that if they became strong again, they will turn to trying to destroy the actual Christians, who they see as rebels and people to be dominated by Frankie and the pillocks in the frocks, the local parish perverts. Because they absolutely hate Jesus Christ. They hate him. They are enemies of the cross of Jesus Christ. They're not in the good of his work. There's no God work in them. And they are killing God's people in the name of him who gave his life to save people from sin. The time will come when they that kill you think that they do God's service. Catholics have done it through history. The Jews have done it. And the Muslims do it. Because the Muslims believe that Ishmael was the chosen son, not Isaac from Abraham. And therefore all the Jews and Christians are invalidated. It can only be the only valid people. If that were true, the only valid people would be Muhammad the warlord, inventor prophet of Islam. But actually, of course, Ishmael was the rejected son when the Lord God of Israel sent him away with his mother, get lost. And he derived, the Lord Jesus brought about Jacob, and from Jacob the 12 tribes, and from there they built Israel of the Old Covenant. Now we belong to Israel, New Covenant, spiritual Israel. But don't be surprised if these people, the spiritual, the religious aspirants, those that really want to try and save their own soul by doing church and applications of theology and beliefs and all kinds of stuff, don't be surprised if they start turning once again to attacking and killing the actual disciples, because the actual disciples actually have Christ. They're only religious about him. It could happen, you know. It could happen to us all. Now just be wise. Don't you ever think that Frankie's mob is anything to do with the Lord Jesus Christ. They've got blood on their hands and a long, long history of downright nastiness, and they have pariah status for all eternity. And mercifully, we'll see the Lord Jesus throw them in the lake of fire, and that'll be the end of that. But it's not our job to sort these people out. We ignore them, we let them get on with it, and we just walk on. Let's beware the religious aspirant and those people who name the name of Jesus Christ but not actually the Lord, such as you see on, say, Revelation TV or God TV. So some of you are familiar with God TV, certainly I've spoken about it. They're religious aspirants, they're not actually his people at all. They will turn to killing. They'll join up with Frankie, and they'll try and attack and subjugate God's people. I suspect, you know that scripture about Revelation, I suspect that the scripture talks about they were going to make an image of the beast, and the beast appears to be Satan himself, who is about to be revealed in Satan's world headquarters in Rome, introduced probably by Frankie in the Frock, or one of his followers, his successors, is my take on it. But however, it appears to be an image of Satan, and cause this image to speak and cause all those who will not bow to this idol. They're good at bowing. They bow to idols all the time, the Catholics. They've got the idol of the Eucharist, the idol of the goddess Mary. They've got idols all over the place, and they bow to altars and all kinds of other sick stuff which Jesus did not ordain. But nevertheless, I think that maybe that'll happen soon. Satan will order this. There'll be images of Satan around the place during the time of Satan's reign. He comes first, and probably soon. And we'll be forced either to bow to these idols, or we'll say, no, that's not Jesus, that's Satan. And the price of that is going to be execution. But beware, it's going to be Christians, nominally Christian people, who will turn against us and will turn to killing the actual Christians. Evil, wicked people do evil wickedness. If they were good, they'd do good, wouldn't they? But they do wickedness because they ain't born again. Beware. Brace yourself. This could get nasty.